हेलो। या हाय अमित एंड जोसेफ, दिस इज प्रवीण। आर यू एबल टू हियर मी क्लियरली?
Yes, Pravin.
ओके ओके एंड आर यू एबल टू सी माय स्क्रीन?
Yes.
ओके, सो आई विल जस्ट गिव स्मॉल इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट माई सेल्फ, देन यू कैन गिव योर इंट्रोडक्शन ऑन इन रिलेटेड टू एस ए पी साइट, देन वी कैन सी द डेमो। ओके, I am working for SAP for more than 7 years, and I am a SAP certified consultant in SD and the CRM, and have done various projects in SD and as well as in CRMs. And training is one of my passion. I mean, it's like a hobby itself. I mean, I used to take training when I'm at free times. So that's all about myself. And may I know, I mean, your a brief introduction about in SAP line, or I mean, if you're not in SAP line, if you're intending to move to SAP line, I mean, just a small introduction about you both.
Can you be a bit louder? That will be great, Praveen.
My maximum, I mean, no.
Okay. All right.
Because I have kept the mic volume full, so that's the maximum. Amit, may I know your introduction, please?
Okay. I am a project manager since last few years, and I have been working with some multinationals. I was lastly with Ericsson, and nowadays I am in Ahmedabad due to some family commitments and working for a small company.
Okay.
I don't have much of experience on SAP. Actually,
Okay.
none of my experience in SAP, but from the Oracle app side and the other legacy ERP, I have some experience on it. So,
Okay.
in fact, this CRM thing also, like not the CRM, but BI thing, OBIE, business, Oracle side, Oracle app side. I have
Okay.
some experience, and I know
Okay.
the CRM side. So
Okay.
this is what it is, and I'm looking for. I may go for the certification also. So I would need all that info, and I would need some real-time examples so that I am I can get a feel of the application.
Okay.
I want a real-time feel of it. That's it.
Okay. And Joseph, I mean, may I have your introduction?
I'm into Oracle applications, and I have been in Oracle application for past 10 years. Okay,
Okay.
and I have been into the field of for CRM and SCM. Okay, and basically, I just want to have a crossover of other applications as well.
Okay.
Okay, and probably I may also go for certifications, okay, because it's the market is also demanding that after a level, you don't stick to one application ERP. You need to go into a multiple level.
Yes.
Okay,
Yes.
multiple ERP. Okay, I just want to have a because CRM as such, it's very clear that it is only a front-end tool, but I will be looking forward how it gets integrated with SD module and the finance as well.
Okay.
Okay, because I'm pretty much sure I know how Oracle works, okay, across all these areas, business areas like finance, SCM, and CRM are working.
Okay.
But I just want to have to start with CRM, but I just want to know flow till the financial part.
Okay. Okay.
But, okay.
Fine, I understand. So I'll just show you. I mean, the content course content. I mean, how we will be going forward. I mean, if you have the trainings, okay. So when I take the course, to 90% of the questions come from this layer, base customize. Okay, this is the part where functional consultants should know where exact location SAP CRM, what to change as per the client requirement. So there are 10 topics, okay, this SAP CRM, and for the first one is about the architecture part, then comes the business partner. So business partner is where you arrange your customer master data. So this is the functionality where you do a lot of things related to accounts, that is accounts management. You can say there are several names like account management or business partner or customer master data, you can name it. Then you have the organizational management, that is from your client side, if you think about your client's organization structure, how their organization structure is. The same thing, the same layers, each layer like sales organization or a marketing organization or a service organization. So within the organization, there will be sub levels. Everything can create the SAP CRM.
Can you be a bit slow? That would be great.
Okay, fine. So, and we have some more functionalities like product master. And in this product master, we'll be learning how to create products. There are different product types that we have in SAP CRM. Let's say client is using tangible products, let's say a material. Okay, you can use the product type as material. Let's say the client is using a product kind like a service product, then you can create service products in this product master. Let's say in the same manner, like if it is a warranty product, you can create a warranty product. If you use something like a financial product, like in banking, they usually have the product as a forms, like personal loan, you have one form, saving accounts, another form. So all those things are nothing but financial products in the banking industry. So whenever a banking industry wanted to implement SAP CRM, under the product master, they will go for financial, they will create financial products. So in the same manner, so all these things, why we create all these things, first is, the main thing is the transaction process. So this is the place where the business runs. So in each company, they have their own process. Process in the sense, CRM is mostly focused on three processes. One is called sales process, service process and marketing process. So in these processes, how this transaction processing functionality is used, what all the controls are with this transaction functionality. So in each topics, what I have showing, there are several subtopics also. So those things will be seeing, during the training part.
So the transaction focuses on three processes. What three processes you said? I'm sorry.
Process, service process and marketing process. Okay, I'm just giving a higher level overlook. Then I will show you, for your clarity, I will show you one more document where you can have a gist about the whole CRM. The whole. Okay, just get a small glance and you can have. So I'm just showing you the 85 to 90% of the certification come from this layer. Okay, these are the topics. Then, since you are, whenever you are doing a SAP CRM certification, there are two levels. The first level is called as associate. The second one is called as professional certificate. Okay, these are the two levels. So basically, if you want to do a CRM, first thing is you have to clear the associate level. Then only you can go for the professional level certification. So from the association point of view, these things, these are the CRM, SAP CRM sales, SAP CRM service, and SAP CRM marketing. These are the three sub-modules in CRM, that is what I was telling, the process, CRM sales, CRM service, and CRM marketing. So under these processes, you have some few functionalities which is given by SAP CRM. Okay. Then finally, there are something called channels, something like SAP CRM Interaction Center. What does it mean? It's like whenever you purchase some product and then after usage of 4 or 6 months, you give a call to the customer either because your product is not working or to write some complaint, and that from the company side, agent will pick your call. So that is called as Interaction Center. The agent will get the problem from you. That is, you are the customer, so he'll get the customer complaints, and they will do what they have to do. I mean, they can do the solution then and there if you are raising any questions or any complaints. Otherwise, if the complaint is not able to be solved through the call, then they will create a service order or they will create, a specific process. Send the executive to your place, or they will ask the product to send it to their company place. So all those processes start. So for this, they require a channel. It is called Interaction Center channel. You'll see this part. Then you have something called CRM web client. So usually in CRM, if you want to work in CRM, there are two environments you have. One is, this is called as GUI. I repeat, GUI. Explanation is graphical user interface. So in all the models, SAP, all the models, you can take any model like FICO or MM or SD or PP, any models, they use this environment. That is called GUI. And for CRM, we have one more model, one more environment. It is called as web client. Just showing you. So what is the advantage here is, you can use this using a browser. Basically, you no need to work under the GUI screen. Okay, so in CRM, there is one more advantage is, you no need to work in the SAP GUI screen. There is one more environment the CRM has given, that is called as CRM web client. So I'm just logging in. It takes a little time to open. Just give me a minute. So I'll show you when the page gets loads. Till the time. So I'm just logging in. So this is basically, it is more user friendly. From your client side, whoever is working, under the SAP in CRM functionality, it will be easier for them to handle all the day-to-day process on working on this environment rather than working in this GUI. Okay, this GUI is mainly used by the consultants, like functional consultants, ABAPers, security consultants, there are several consultants out there. So those people use this customizing for all those things in the GUI. But for the day-to-day transactions, everything, the user point of view, they will use this CRM web client, it is shortly called as. So that the screens come till the time, I'm just taking the content. So under this CRM web client, there are some more few functionalities. So we'll see what are the main functionalities in this topics. Okay, then comes the CRM middleware. So this is the part, the integrations, everything happens. Since SAP CRM is used as a front-end system, so how SAP CRM can be connected to SAP system, or it can be connected to a non-SAP system also. So let's say SAP can be connected to your PeopleSoft system, SAP can be connected to your different non-SAP system, or it can be connected to, let's say, from your Lotus Notes, you want to connect to CRM, you can connect. From the MS Outlook, you want to connect to CRM, you can connect. So likewise, everything can be done under this topic called SAP CRM middleware. So this is the functionality. So under this functionality only, you can do integrations between other models. It can be a SAP model also, or it can be non-SAP model also. Both the things, it allows you for data exchange. So these are the topics we cover in the training course. Okay, I'm just showing you this CRM web client. Let's take Interaction Center agent. So this requires a little patience. Since it is a training client, it takes time, but in the live project, whenever you open, it will immediately get opens. So this is how the screen looks like for SAP CRM using CRM Web Client Environment. As I told you, this is one layer, GUI. Here also you can work all the functionalities. And there is one more. This is also one environment where you can work related pertain to the specific functionalities. Like for example, process like sales process, you can work in this. So if you want to go to service process, you need to choose the another one. I mean, depends upon the users. Let's say you have sales team, you have service team, you have marketing team. So within each team, there are some few members working under the team. Okay, let's say when sales member want to work for the sales process later, they come to CRM the point, they need to choose the specific role. Okay, a role can be a sales professional. So when they choose the specific sales professional role, then they will get only the functionalities which is related to sales. Okay, in the same manner, when the service department, I mean a service person, I mean gets inside the CRM web client, they can see only the service related functionalities. In the same manner for marketing person, they can see only the marketing related functionalities. So this is how the advantage of both the SAP CRM web client. It's very user friendly from the user perspective. So from now, this is the course content which I have just walked through. So I'll just go a little bit about the CRM. So basically, CRM is a concept first. It has been evolved from the business side. I mean, after sales and after the service, and how to optimize the customer interaction. At that point only, I mean, CRM, the concept, the whole business strategy evolved. Okay. Then several companies started using different tools in CRM. And in SAP, at that time only they were using all the ERP concepts like they created these few models like finance model, then MM model, then SP model. Likewise, they started creating several models. So CRM is, SAP CRM has evolved during that time when all these models are already created. Those models are called as core models. Okay, FICO, SD, MM, EP, QM, all these SAP models are called as core models. So next to these core models, it is called as SAP New Dimension models. So in that SAP New Dimension model, one of the model is the CRM. So I'll just show you how the SAP CRM has come, how it has been evolved. So if you see this one, the very first screen I'm just showing you. Let me maximize. So this is the SAP CRM site. Okay. So before SAP CRM, under SAP, there are several models already created. That is the finance model, and you can see some of the like quality model. On the right side, you can see sales and distribution model. On the left side, you can see purchase order model, inventory management model. These are the core models. Okay. So then SAP realized to have some more functionalities which give additional profit, additional business to the clients. So in that way, they chosen these four models. So the first one is like My SAP CRM, which connects the SAP SD model, and from there it takes to the customer place. I mean, from customer side, it connects between the customer interaction. So the main importance about the My SAP CRM is how all you can interact with the customer. I mean, how you can enhance your customer service part in the business. In the same manner, you have My SAP SCM. This is also one new dimension model. It is called as supply chain management. In the same manner, we have SRM, that is supplier relationship management, and you have this something called PLM, that is product lifecycle management. So these are called as new dimension products. And here we are focusing on My SAP CRM right now. So let's see within My SAP CRM what all the things available. And here whatever I have shown is it shows My SAP, My SAP, My SAP, right? Earlier we say as SAP, a brand, okay, then they have changed the brand name as My SAP. That's why in everywhere you can see My SAP, My SAP, My SAP. So now, I mean, whenever they create their new model, I mean, the brand name is called My SAP, they will say. Let's take a company. If you see the company, within a company, there are several departments out there, okay. So in these departments, just imagine where all you can have the customer interaction. So if you think in that way, there are few departments like marketing department, sales department, and service department. So in these departments only, the customer interactions happens. Okay, so that is why in SAP CRM, the whole SAP CRM, they have subdivided into SAP CRM marketing, SAP CRM sales, and SAP CRM service. And on the left side, you can see analytics. Analytics is one of the sub-model where you can do analytical work for marketing process, for sales process, and for service process. So as a holistically, if you see my SAP CRM as a whole tool, so within that, according to the client, let's say your client is using marketing, I mean, let's say your client is having a marketing organization, then you can choose my SAP CRM marketing. Let's say your client is having manufacturing and they are selling the products, then you can have sales. Let's say your client is having sales plus service also, then you can use SAP CRM sales plus service. Let's say your company is using, I mean, your client is using all the three. I mean, they have the marketing process, they have the sales process, they have the service process. It's well and fine that they can completely use the whole SAP CRM functionality with the analytics. So this is how this whole SAP CRM concept, the models, everything came up. So now let's see what all the key processes available in this marketing model. Okay, so if you think from the marketing side, let's be like a marketing manager. If you think from the marketing side, some of the key processes are like the campaign management. One of the very first process starts from the marketing is the campaign, that is marketing plan. Let's say, I mean, you need to plan about your products, I mean, how to sell it. And for that, you need to arrange some campaigns. Campaigns can be like giving some special offers, giving some discount to the product on a specific day, like, I mean, for Diwali, I mean, you can do some discounts to your products, or some of the validity period, during the some certain validity period, let's say from Jan to March, you can sell some products which are not having a good sale in the last quarter. So for those products, you can give some discounts and you can select the customers and can send the campaigns to them. Campaigns can be like, I mean, on your day-to-day life, you will be getting some SMS through campaigns, SMS campaigns, or through email, you will be getting some campaigns, or through telephone, I mean, telemarketing, you will be getting some campaigns. People will be asking you, this is a new product, is there, or are you interested in it? So those are nothing but campaign management. So SAP CRM supports this key process in marketing. Then you have customer segmentation. What is customer segmentation? Let's say in your company, you have more than, let's say you have 1,000 customers within your company. Okay, so for these 1,000 customers, when you're doing a campaign, you don't want to give all the, I mean, the provided discounts to all the 1,000 customers. You want to segregate from the 1,000 customers. So let's say only for those 100 customers who are loyal to you, I mean, who are, I mean, buying your products on a periodic basis, for them you want to give some certain discounts. Okay, so how you categorize those things, you can do it under this functionality called customer segmentation. You segregate your customer base accordingly and you target only those customers, and for them you send the specific discounts through campaigns. So that is one of the functionality, the process. And you have lead management. What is lead management? Let's say you have created a campaign and you have targeted some customers and you have provided the information to the customers. And within that 100 customers whomever you have targeted and you have sent the campaigns to them, okay, so let's say at least 50 people are interested. Okay, so those are little interested. So those are called as lead. So from there the lead management starts. Let's say, I mean, few customers within the 50, I mean, some people are very much interested, like 10 people are very much interested to buy, I mean, right now 20 people are thinking about it, let's say they will buy within 1 week or after a month. So those are called as warm lead, cold lead. So likewise, we classify, you can qualify the lead. So all the things done under the lead management. In the same manner, SAP CRM, they use the marketing part also. You can do e-marketing. Let's say whenever you open any websites nowadays, on the left side, on the right side, you'll have some advertisements. So all those things are nothing but the e-marketing side. And in the marketing process, you can do the marketing planning and analytics. So all the process, I mean, what are the process shown? For all the things, you can analyze. Let's see how the process, how well the process has gone. And how you can see it. And like marketing process, I mean, like marketing functionality, whatever I have shown you, if I go to the sales, in SAP CRM, there are several key processes in sales. One is called customer order management. I mean, the whole order management, like whenever a customer purchases a specific order, and you need to take the order from there, the delivery process, and from the delivery process, the billing process, and once the billing process is done, within the delivery itself, there are sub processes like picking, packing, then you are sending the goods to the customer, the customer receives the goods. So all those things come covered from the customer order management. Quotation. Quotation is before the order. Whenever the customer wants to purchase, you need to send some proposal to the customers. Okay, so that the customer sees what is the material, what is the price you are giving, and after that, once they are okay with the quotation, then only can create orders. Let's say contracts. Contracts are nothing but customers. Who are having an agreement with your company.
Hello.
Let's say for 1 year.
Hello.
Yeah. Hi.
I think there's a lot of noise, and I can barely hear you.
Okay. Both of you, can you please mute in the GoToMeeting? Under the GoToMeeting, you can see mics right on your name on the left side. Just click it once so that it will be muted. See your name, mic symbol. Just click on the mic symbol so it will be muted.
Yeah, it can.
If you mute means, I don't know from where the noise is coming, it can be restricted. Okay, I hope now you don't find the noise. Okay. So if you have any questions, you need to unmute that. You need to click again. Then only, your voice will be, everybody can listen. Okay. So if you have any questions, you just unmute and then ask. Till now, let's keep it in mute only so that you don't need to have any disturbance. So we are discussing about the another process, that is a sales process. So under the sales process, what all the process, what all the functionalities SAP CRM provides? One of the functionality we have discussed is customer order management, quotation management, contracts. In the same manner, you have something called account and contact management. That is nothing but creation of your customer base. That is customer master data. So how well you can create the customer master data, all those things you will be seeing under this. Then you have this opportunity management and pipeline analysis. Let's say, what is opportunity management? It's a very new thing in SAP CRM. So what is an opportunity management means? If you think from a sales perspective, let's say you are a sales manager or a sales representative, from that angle if you think, let's say you want to target a customer, and that customer is a company itself. Okay, you're working for a company, and your customer is also another company, and for that company you're going to target, you're expecting some sales from that customer. Okay, so here the process is sales process, not like just a 1 month or 15 days process. Let's say this process, it continues for more than 3 months or 4 months to convert the prospect into sales. So during those process, you use this opportunity management. The sales process, which is too long, for converting into sales or into contract, for those purpose you use opportunity management. So in this opportunity management, SAP CRM provides wide functionalities like the phases wise. You can segregate the phases. Let's say first phase, you need to meet the customer. Second phase, you need to send your proposals to them. And the third phase, you need to give presentations. And the fourth phase, you can make decision makings. So in these phases, under these phases, what all the activities you have to do, what all the activities the representative has to do, what all the activities the sales manager has to do, everything will be clearly mentioned in SAP CRM so that the users can, under the SAP CRM, they can perform and they can easily win the calls, sales calls from the customers. So that in that way, there is one functionality, the process of opportunity management. Then you have activity management. Activity management is one of the superb functionality in SAP CRM. Let's say internally within the company, okay, let's say I am the manager and you are my subordinate. If I want to communicate to you everything, the whole interaction, let's say I can, I mean, in your, basically in your company, I can just walk to your desk, I can tell you some task. Otherwise, I can send through email and you will receive the email and you will do the task. So this is how, I mean, most of the companies does. In SAP CRM, when you implement SAP CRM, within SAP CRM, something called, you have task, okay. Let's say I can assign any task, let's like we both are going to meet a customer, so I'm just asking you to do some presentation works, okay, or let's fix an appointment to the customer. So all those things, whatever I'm telling, each is a task, okay, like fixing an appointment, that is a task, or making a presentation, that is a task, okay, sending an email to the customer, that is also a task. So all those tasks will be executed within SAP CRM and it will be recorded as a transaction. So anytime, if you have any doubt, anything, if you want to, want to clarify, everything will be there in the history under the transactions. So in SAP CRM, you no need to miss out any transactions. So, I mean, what all the things you discuss with your colleagues, everything will be recorded in the SAP CRM. This is very much used, let's say in banking industries, when you walk to the bank and when you're asking for some request, service request, okay, nowadays I think HDFC Bank use this. So whenever you get inside the HDFC Bank, there will be an executive who will be recording your interaction. That is, what or anything, I want to have the statement, I want to check my personal loan details, or I want to make the disbursement of loan. Whatever you go through activity. And in the same manner, activity management, you can use for internal purpose and also you can use it for external purpose. External purpose means when you're dealing with the customers, when you're dealing with the vendors, and when you're dealing with the suppliers. For all those things also, you can do activity management. So that is one key process. And you have incentive and commission management. So incentive and commission management, as the name implies, let's say, the sales representative, whoever works for the specific call, and they will finish the call, and you need to provide some commissions to that executive or the representative, okay. So in CRM, at what level you have to give the commission to the specific executive? It can be after the sales, or it can be after the delivery. After the delivery to the customer, you can give the commission to the sales executive, or it can be after the billing part, you can give the commission to the sales executive. So all those things you can, do it under the SAP CRM automatically. This will avoid the favorism. In company there are several favorism happens between the manager and the sales executive. So all those things can be eradicated using this SAP CRM, using this incentive and commission management. So likewise, in sales process itself, you have several key processes you have. And for all these processes, you can do planning and you can do analytical work, everything you can do under the sales process. So in the same manner, you have one more thing called service. So predominantly in SAP CRM, most of the service companies, okay, they use this SAP CRM for service related activities. So because SAP CRM can be used as a standalone product also, you don't need to have a backend SAP ECC system when you are working for let's say for only purely service industries or purely marketing industries, you can just implement only SAP CRM. You don't need to have any SAP ECC for all those things. Let's say for finance model alone, you can have some third party tool and you can implement with it, because SAP CRM is such a tool that you can integrate with any other system. Okay. So let's say in customer interaction service, the key process, what SAP CRM provides is service request, whenever the customer service request, and service order. From the complaint, you will decide, let's say, okay, I need to send a specific representative to the customer place. So for that, you will create a service order. Or if you that you can create, you can deal with the contracts. Let's say you have a contract from a specific customer, and if the customer gives a complaint, and the system will come to know immediately that it will flash it and to say, okay, there is a contract between this customer for these products, so we can give free of charge service. So likewise, there is something called complaint management, how to handle the complaints. And there is something called case management. Case management, just for your understanding, I'm just telling. Case management is nothing but, let's say, in a day, 10 customers are calling the interaction agent, okay, like a call center. And they are giving a same problem, okay. They are giving same problem for a product. Let's say an air conditioner. and in their air conditioner some noise is coming, and all the 10 customers are giving specific complaint on this. Okay, so what the executive can do is they can combine all these 10 customer problems. That is, all the customer problems are same, so they can combine and put it in one case. So for this case, they will process it and they'll give the solution. So automatically that solution will be given to all the 10 customers. So in this way, they can minimize the time taken in dealing with the each customers. So that is called as case management. So likewise, you have something called install based management. Install based management, let's say for example, you have some of the products, you sell it to the customer, and you go to the customer place and you install that product. A fair example is like taking a lift, setting up the lift. Whenever you purchase a lift for an apartment, the manufacturer, the person who has sold the lift, they will come and they will do the installation. Or a simple example, you take an air conditioner. So when you purchase the air conditioner, so after that, the service people will come and they will install the air conditioner. Okay. So in that, say let's say you have installed the air conditioner. So in this scenario, so after 3 or 4 months, let's say you are having some problems with the air conditioner. Okay, and you call the specific call center for the company. So basically what they do is, whenever you give a call, they will ask what is the product, and from the product they will come to know what is the install base number is. There is a unique number for each equipment what they sell to the customer. Okay, so using that unique number, that is called IBase, it's shortly called as, or install base. Using that, they will easily come to know, so okay, this product is located, under this customer location, under this address, under this area, under this state, and under this component, under this equipment, what all the components are there. Let's say within the air conditioner, there are several sub-components are there. So all those things will be listed under this install base. So they will easily predict, as per the customer complaint, they will easily come to know which component would have gone. Okay. So whenever they are sending the service representative, basically they will have a little knowledge that, okay, using the equipment, that is the install based management, they will come to know, okay, some components would have gone. For that, he will collect the spare parts and he will go to the customer place, and if the problem is the same thing, they will just immediately change the spare parts and give the solution to the customer problem. So in that way, install based management is very much useful. Then you have knowledge management. Knowledge management is like, whenever you go to any website, for example, you go to website, any company's website, and there you can see a FAQ, that is frequently asked questions. That is nothing but for the example of knowledge management telling. So whenever you got any problem, if you go to frequently asked questions and if you read those questions, in there itself, if you're for your problem, the solution is there, you can easily understand, you can get the things and you can sort it down by yourself. That is a self-help kind. So for that, you will be, SAP CRM can provide knowledge management. So within the SAP CRM tool, you can create knowledge management and give it to the customer side. And you have this workflow and escalation management. So within from the complaint, whenever you talk about the complaints, you need to have some escalation side, like the customer gives the complaint and the agent receives the call, receives the complaint, and from there the agent has to move the complaint to the service department, and from the service department, service manager checks the complaint and he will assign to a specific service representative, and service representative check the complaint and go to the customer place, repair it and give the service confirmation, and after that you'll go do the billing to the customer. So this is nothing but a process, a workflow. So in that itself, escalation means, let's say a customer has given a complaint and it was not given any response from the company side. So basically you can escalate it, so to the next level. So the system will automatically escalate. If the status is not changed within 1 day or 2 days, it will start escalating to next level. So in this way you can handle using SAP CRM. Then you have this workforce management.
I just want to clarify one doubt, okay? Because in service industry, escalation is a critical part. Okay, I just have one clarification on escalation management. What type of escalation does SAP handles? Because broadly, we
SAP
have a different type.
Escalation, it just purely depends upon, there is a functionality called a schema. Okay, there you define what type of escalation you want, like under SLA. So all those things will be defined under that part. Within 1 day or within time, time limits. So all these things.
Yeah,
that, so that only you can.
Yeah, in that case, then it is going to be reactive. escalation, because there is something like preventive escalation and reactive escalation.
This is purely, I mean, it happens like, assume the scenario is whenever the customer gives a call, and from there it will, I mean, whenever the agent will prepare a specific service.
Hello? Sorry. Hello?
And from, hello?
Hello? Yeah, I'm not able to hear you. Hello? Hello?
Can you hear me now? Yeah,
yeah.
I can hear you.
Yes,
is this Joseph?
Yeah, this is Joseph.
Yeah, I can hear you. I mean, now.
Okay.
See, as per the business requirement, you can customize the escalation level in SAP CRM.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay. No,
I'm audible to you.
You are audible, but see, actually, as a standard, preventive is something like on a standardized business will always have a preventive. But for example, if you have an SLA that within a day the resolution has to happen, and there is no progress on the escalation on the resolution part, okay, within 24 hours. So after the 18 hours, it will you will have a notification to the to the engineer or to the person who is handling the
all
case.
These things will be handled in different functionality in SAP CRM. Okay, so escalation part, I am giving the escalation management here. Okay, so let's say I am just giving a proper scenario. The customer gives a call, and the agent creates a service request on it. Okay, and let's say on today's date and time.
Okay.
So let's say this SLA, we have to give the solution to the customer within 2 days' time. So now the agent creates a service request. After that, automatically using the workflow, it will create a service order. So the service manager will check the service order and he will assign a service employee. The service employee go to the customer place, and the service employee is not able to fix the call or fix the not able to perform the specific task. Okay, so it's getting delayed. So during that time, the service employee, what he can do is there is some more activities. I mean, I have told you, right? Something called as activity management. I mean, the specific. I have shown you something like.
Yeah, yeah.
We have something called actions. So using these functionalities, it will start triggering the specific notifications to each of the peoples. Okay, you say like a preventive action, or you say like a corrective actions. So immediately the system will start giving the specific notification to those people who are concerned to it. Okay, so easily they will just go and they will check it, and immediately they will take the backup action and they will try to complete the customer call. I mean, customer problem, and they will solve the problem. So this is how, I mean, in SAP CRM works. There are several functionalities. That's why I told you the base customizing is very important.
Yeah, got it.
And you have this. And you have this workforce management. Could you please mute it, Joseph?
Yeah.
And you have this workforce management. Workforce management is like how well you plan your resources. So you have a specific department. Under the department, there are several employees are there in the service industries I'm talking. So whenever you get a service order call, I mean, in a day, and you need to check, I mean, which of the resources are available, and you will assign to the specific available resources. So all those things take care under the workforce management. So in the same way, you have this professional services part. So where it's like the representative who travels from one place to another place to reach the customer location to give the professional service for them. What are the the functionalities process we have in SAP CRM? So all these things come under the key processing service. So I have just shown you the submodels in SAP CRM: sales, service, and marketing. There is one more thing you need to understand from SAP CRM point of view, that is called as channels. Okay, what is channels means? I have just shared with you the departments. There is a department called marketing, sales, and service. Okay, so how these departments get connected to the customer side? So there are four channels SAP CRM has provided. Okay. So you can use any one, or you can use all. All this depends upon the purely depends upon the client's requirement only. What is their business process accordingly? Let's say first is the e-commerce. E-commerce, that is through internet, you can
connect the customer using marketing, e-marketing, e-sales, e-service. Okay, so this is one platform where you can connect the customer. Second is the interaction center. So through the interaction center, let's say the customer can give you a call to the call center under the marketing department or a sales department or a service department. In turn, the marketing people or a sales people or service people can give you a call to the customer. That is another channel. Then you have field. Field is nothing but the representative go physically to the customer place for marketing or sales or service related process. And there is one more thing called channel partners. Channel partner is something like an indirect way of dealing the business. Let's say, for example, in sales, you have companies like Maruti Udyog manufacturer. So, they are manufacturer of cars. Okay. So, if you want to purchase a specific car from Maruti, what do? You can't directly go to the manufacturer Maruti. So, you'll go to the dealers, you go to the resellers. From them, you'll purchase the car. So, those comes under the channel partners. So, these are the channels, available channels through which you interact the customers. Okay, so as a whole, in SAP CRM, there are key processes like sales, service, and marketing. So these things are classified as submodels: SAP CRM sales, SAP CRM service, SAP CRM marketing. Apart from that, you have this customer interaction channels. So channel is nothing but in which way you connect to the customer. So from here, what I'll show you is, I'll just take you a small business case, so where you'll understand where you can easily put all the things whatever you have seen in the scenario. Let's say my SAP CRM analytics. So this is one of the model. Let's say in this model, let's say an analyst checks the sales distribution and classifies customers. What does it mean? Means, let's say last 6 months, the analyst checks how well the sales process has gone. He will classify the customers, all the customers, okay, and for these customers he will create a new campaign. Let's say he is giving some specific special discounts to these customers, okay, and he will execute this campaign. Let's say one of the customer from this target group checks through a web shop. There is a channel. SAP CRM e-commerce is a channel. So right now we have just discussed analytics is a model, marketing is a sub-model, and here comes the channel part. So let's say the customer checks through the website of the company and gets the information about the campaign, and the customer is interested to purchase the product. Okay, so this became a lead. So this lead will be handled by the channel manager who sits in the company. So what the channel manager does, he will send this lead to the specific partners. Partners can be like a dealer or reseller, whoever is closer to the customer place, customer location. So those dealers, resellers will create the sales order for this customer. And after the sales order, for the sales alone, once you create the sales order in SAP CRM, the sales order will be replicated to SAP ECC, where you have this SD model. So under the SD model, you have the delivery process. Because in SAP CRM, we cannot handle delivery process. Okay, SAP CRM cannot handle delivery process. That's why we replicate the SAP CRM sales order, whichever we create, and we'll pass it to the SAP ECC SD model. So under the SD model, we have the delivery process. Delivery process can be like a picking process, packing process, transportation process. So all those things comes under the SAP SD. So there is one line. So from the SAP SD, the delivery happens to the customer, and those status, delivery status, everything will be again passed to the SAP CRM sales order. Okay. So in this way, in the SAP CRM also, you can see the status about the delivery, all those things in the SAP CRM itself. So now, what happens is the customer has received the goods, let's say, okay, and after a few weeks or a few months, the customer is giving a call in the call center, that is the interaction center. So the agent, whoever is attending the call, will receive the customer complaint. Let's say there is a complaint which the customer is given. So now what the agent does is, she will pass this complaint and create a service order. So the service manager use the SAP CRM service and assign a specific representative in the service order. Okay, now once this service order, in the service order the service executive has been assigned, let's say the service employee, whoever is in the whoever is in the field, they will come to know, okay, there is a service order assigned to me. So he will check the service order using this field application. There is one more channel, so he will check it and he will go to the customer place and he will solve the customer problem and he will give the service confirmation. So in this whole business case, if you see analytics, marketing, sales and service, okay, these are the sub models in SAP CRM. Apart from this, if you see e-commerce, channel management, interaction center and field applications, all these are called as channels. That is, we have seen the just above the screen, you have seen the channels part, right? This one. Okay, so this is how the whole SAP CRM has been designed. And it doesn't mean that you have to know everything in SAP CRM for marketing, sales and service. Okay, so purely as per the customer's requirement, I mean, if it is a marketing organization, you will only sell, I mean, they will only purchase SAP CRM marketing. That is sufficient for them. Only those functionalities. If the client is using the only service organization, I mean, related to service process, you can use only the SAP CRM service. If any client is using all the three, then you can use the all the three. This is how this whole SAP CRM package, I mean, SAP has provided. That's it from my side. I mean, if you have any questions, you can post. I can unmute and you can ask.
Naveen, you will be taking the training, or you have anyone else who will be doing it, or it is only you?
This is Praveen. Naveen is the coordinator.
Okay, sorry.
I'll be taking it.
Okay, and second thing is that how about the instance access? How long will we be able to get the instance access? And
Okay. A few things I'll just clarify to you. Okay. The training part I will take. Okay. And even the documents which I am taking in the class, I will share. Okay. This is from my side. The server access, okay, will be provided by if your contact person is Naveen, then I mean Naveen will provide you the server access. And basically I assume they will provide you for 3 months, okay, for practice purpose it can be. Then even you get the recording videos also of the training. So each class you will get the recording also, so that provision also they will provide you. And the timings. Timing is purely, I mean, on your convenient time. I mean, let's say you can fix the timing in your weekdays or in your weekends. It purely depends upon your timing, because for me, what happens is once you give the timing, I mean, then only I will get committed. So basically, I mean, I want to know, I mean, your working timings, everything. Then only, I mean, we can set a specific class and run the class through weekdays or through weekends, the morning time.
Yeah, this is a very critical area where we need to be a little more flexible on it.
Very simple. I'll tell you. Yeah. I'm free and you are free and we are in a mood to take. I mean, to have the class. Then fine. That's it. Okay. So just, I mean, before. experts in SAP CRM.
Yeah, that's what. And you know, that's what is the thing. Like, I should land up in a job. That's what I'm looking for. You know, and I don't know if you guys don't give any guarantee to it, but that's my motto. That's what I'm looking for. So okay, thanks a lot.
SAP CRM is a very hot skill, Amit. Okay, right now currently SAP CRM is one of the hot skill only. Okay, there are only few modules right now in SAP hot and in the SAP CRM. Even if you join companies like, for example, Accenture, had an offer, but I haven't joined. So they give hot skill bonus also. So since you have the skill set of SAP CRM, they'll give hot skill bonus also along with the compensation.
Yes, I have worked with Capgemini for long.
Okay.
So at that time it was IBM A400. You know, I was on the mid-range server. So
okay.
I know that you know, these companies. In fact, the tech companies like Tech Mahindra also gives.
So in that, what I'm telling is, I mean, SAP CRM still, I mean, there are several requirements out there. I mean, if you just update your resume in putting SAP CRM somewhere, you'll be getting mails and calls. That's now.
Yeah, that's the thing actually. To learn it first and then you know, start searching for it.
Okay.
Yeah. And even the sales function, like I was business engagement manager in Ericsson, and like we used to have this.
Ericsson means, I think Accenture was supporting. I mean, they have the SAP implementation with Accenture.
Oh, they have for my time booking. You know, I have to go to the cost center, and you know, we had SAP HR module implemented.
No, what I'm telling is, the support was given from Accenture. That's what I.
That could be possible because at that time.
I know. Because one of my friend works for client Ericsson. I mean, he works for Accenture, but the client is Ericsson. So through that.
And other thing is, I am PMP certified. I am a project manager.
Okay.
So you know, I don't want to start afresh as a fresher because I'm having 14 years of experience, 14 years of experience.
Yeah, I mean, with your experience, I mean, if you know the knowledge, then it's fine. I mean, you'll be
doing the knowledge.
Planning.
I just have to get used to this tool, and you know,
start
where I am right now. Start from there.
Yeah. It'll be easier for you in decision making, in certain times.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And Praveen, I have a last question for you. Is it something like, because Amit is also there, because is it something like it is on an individual basis or it is a team? Because if you are expecting like
it's purely depends upon you guys. I mean, if you want to have individual class, I don't mind also. I mean, if you happen to have both, I mean, I don't mind. It's depends upon even Naveen. I mean, you need to check with the Naveen. I mean, if your both timings fits, then well and fine. And if your both timings not fitting, I mean, my timing, I mean, three of your timings is fitting well and fine, then fine, you can have one class. And if at all not having, I mean, I'm just assuming if you have both of you in the same class, let's say in one class you are not able to attend, and in one class Amit is not able to attend. Okay, so I take individual class also. There's nothing, no problem.
Okay.
It's everything. I mean, we three of you should have the time frame. I mean, on that day.
Okay.
So it's very flexible. I mean, you don't have to worry about the timing.
Okay.
So
basically,
I take
class for like 1.5 hours to 2 hours. So because each topic will take at least to cover 2 hours to understand the whole concept. So that's why, I mean, the class will be like at least 1.5 hours to 2 hours. If it is for weekdays, if it is weekend means, I mean, I can conduct the class for 3 hours also. But I just want, I mean, your side also, I mean, you should be in a study mode to sit in the, online for 3 hours. I mean, we'll have breaks also in that, that's not the thing. So I'm just giving you, let's say for example, the case, 2 hours, I mean, for, if it is weekdays, we can from Monday to Friday we can have 2 hours, and for weekends we can have for 3 hours. So this is one. And sometimes,
and
even though we, once again, I'll finish it off. Even though we say like Monday to Friday, in some cases, I mean, we may miss class. Like I'm not busy. I mean, I'm not free, or you are busy. So during that, I mean, we skip the classes. So it's like a little alternative. So that is also, I mean, I'm just telling you right now.
Okay, Praveen, I just want to one more info. Like, how long is the course duration?
See, it varies. I mean, from 45 to 50 hours it takes.
Okay.
So it purely depends upon the individual. I mean, how much they. I mean, some people. I mean, if they are having background from sales side and they'll easily quickly know. I mean, about the whole thing. And some people starting from fresh side, then it takes a little time. I mean, for them to. I mean, conduct. I mean, for these hours. So that's why. 45 to 50 hours, I can say. Some classes goes to 60 hours also. I mean, it purely depends upon the student's understanding level also.
Okay.
Fine then. Thanks. Thank you.
Thanks for me.
Okay. Yeah. You please inform to Naveen also. I mean, what are the decisions you are taking? I mean, after you take, you just convey to Naveen. Okay.
Yeah,
I assume Naveen is your contact person, right? Book for both of you?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.